So here we are again. This is a very interesting selection, second part of the Paul Kerr collection. We're starting off with this painting here called Reborn. This takes into account the whole idea of reincarnation. You have this face here and this other face coming from it. It's called Reborn. It's like he's coming from a character in nature. And suddenly he comes out. So this is also could be seen in many lights. We're all looking for to be reborn, especially creatively. This could have to do with Paul's also recent resurgence of art, and you can see it in a lot of his works. Beautiful piece, fantastic colours, brilliant movement. The eggs, the two shells, they're breaking out as well. You know, the background, the nature scene. This is a fantastic piece by Paul. Next, we're going to have a look at The Wave. This is a painting that Paul did over quite a long period of time. There's three different sections to it, so it's quite a large work. But in it, you can see the beautiful water turning. Fantastic colour as the light hits the wave, and then there's this dark background as well. It's full of energy and momentum and life. Shows you that his Paul's very vast range of styles, and someone commented on that recently, but this is another example of what Paul can do. Now we're two paintings which you could say they're familiar Paul Kerr characters. The first one, Caught in the Half Light, there's a kind of a still life here, and then this just character emerges from a very beautiful light background. Typical Paul Kerr face, one eye covered by the hair. Again, here, this one here is the visitor. He's just arrived, or the crow's just arrived. Again, very kind of melancholic face, full of mystery, you know, real person, you know, emerged in his thoughts. And as I said, melancholy, it's a lot like us sometimes, I'm sure, when we meditate like that. They're the two of his more typical Paul Kerr scenes. So now we enter into some of the most dramatic scenes in Paul's collection. There's four pieces here, two of them on the Mad Hatter series, which is taken, of course, from the Wizard of Oz. The Hatter is just a character who comes there and he does all kinds of amazing, strange things. It's a little bit of a commentary, a social commentary here. Now this first part is particularly, I don't want to use the word horrific, but it is Paul's response to the Bataclan disaster in Paris, when there was a music concert went on and some character came in and shot literally dozens of people. And they were trying to escape and they were shot also in the restaurant in Paris. So this is called paranoia. This is what that sort of a thing can do. And again, it's a raw response of Paul's to the current situation. You can see the characters with their open eyes, their open mouths, their startled eyes, and the colour, all the characters pushed together. You know, this could even be some of the characters who died on our time, you know. So Paul has got an absolutely very emotive response to that scene and to all the common scenes that are going on in the world today. We all respond in different ways to these disasters, but Paul is visually doing that. The next piece here is called The Night of the Lizards. So this reminds me of the 1930s artists from Germany, who a lot of the time they depicted some of the scenes which preceded Nazism. So this is Paul's almost futuristic view The Night of the Lizards. You can see the characters coming together, their various faces, their monster-like arm, hands, legs, tongues, and the lizard kind of character there. The embrace here looks like the girl has been almost tortured, but she has these big hands as well. So again, very kind of copper, ochre colours, which depicts an awful lot of the horrors that is in everyday life, that you might say. So again, another response is the a world gone mad. You know, the rabbit has suddenly come in with the teacup, and there's almost like an explosion in the background. Using some of Paul's painting techniques here, this kind of dabbled effect, and the light coming in through, beautiful skin colouring as ever, fabulous range of colours, and then you come close into the eye, and you can see it's a rabbit, but why is he there, what is he doing, you know, so it's like he's an observer of this mad world, the world gone mad. And then the final piece is the return of the Hatter. The rabbit theme again coming up here, but this time another kind of spectre of a character coming out of the light, but the light shining on his face. But it doesn't show us a beautiful portrait character. It shows us a very weird character, you might say, who's coming to tell us about the events of the world today. Thank you very much.